Episode 21, on a Monday, October 10th, 2011. Glenn finally has answers this week to what to do to defend capitalism. Glenn also announces his www.1791.com. That's his clothing line. It's day 24 of the Occupy Wall Street protests, and he gives information of the people who own the park. Brookfield Asset Management owns the park. It's Bloomberg's girlfriend is on the board. And Brookfield Assets hired Biden's lobbying firm, that Joe Biden's, or not Joe Biden's, but it's Joe Biden's lobbying firm. John Lewis is talked about. He wasn't able to speak because the idiots at the Occupy Wall Street voted not to let him speak, so he left. Hilarious. He talked about the Hungary Revolution. It took 12 days to collapse, from revolution to riots to the total collapse. So Glenn didn't know how long it would take for them to try to collapse the system here, if they could ever do it. Glenn announced it's been 200 days ago since Stephen Lerner was put on his program for everyone to see, and there's nothing been done about his trying to collapse Wall Street. Glenn also pinpoints Joel Rogers, not Soros, as the head of Crime Inc. He had on Fox News. He had a whole segment of Crime Inc., and he believes Joel Rogers is the head of it, not Soros. Glenn also mentions in 1992 was when they destroyed the Democratic Party, when all the progressives got in and basically controlled or took over. This is a Glenn Beck quote. "We are in the last phase." Then the news, that's about 43 minutes in. Glenn also had his security chief, Buck Sexton, on a panel, and he was talking with him. I think they talked about how the Occupy Wall Street so organized, and the paper that's put out, Glenn couldn't even, with all his resources, put something like that out. 1791.com is explained. It's to help single moms. They make t-shirts. It's Glenn, and it's basically not a charity, but I don't think he gets any or much money. It just is self-perpetuating kind of a company. I think then after that, he goes into the history of Hungary. Fascinating. You've got to get GBTV. Well worth it. And that's about an hour and 20 minutes in. They ask Raj segment. There was a lot of things that Glenn needs. And one thing he needs is someone to create film, like a director and videographer. He also needs a graphic designer, probably for a real complicated website. He can't do it on his own. I think he quoted a price, in the $70,000 it would cost, or $30,000. I forget exactly, but it was pretty expensive, the website. So he wanted to see if he could get some people to help out on that, so it isn't such an expensive cost. Video production is another, I think, to do segments or, and I don't know if that's for his Liberty Treehouse or segments on the GBTV or all the above. That was Monday's show, episode 22, Tuesday, October 11th, 2011, Occupy Wall Street, day 25. Diane Sawyer made the comment that the protests are in 1,000 countries. She must have misspoke, because there isn't 1,000 countries. I think someone's making something up or trying to exaggerate the scope. Al Sharpton was discussed. Oh, and Paul Krugman was discussed. I guess Glenn found out he was a former Enron advisor. What a weasel that guy is. It's no wonder. 13 minutes in, they have a panel of three people, and they're talking about how to defend capitalism and how to present this to anyone, or like your kids, or you know, anyone who you come up in opposition to. They had one professor have a strategy, and in front of the students, he would spread, well, since, you know, there's so many people getting D's and F's, they're going to spread the people that have too many credits, you know, A plus, whatever. They're going to take their A plus or A and make them be a B and give that one point to the students who are failing so they don't fail. And he explained how that would really wake the students up. All college students were there, I think, and it wasn't, that story wasn't wasted on them. Glenn talks about apprenticeships. and how the college today is so expensive that I think apprenticeships and just really how to do things are being lost, regular things. You'd have to learn, but if some of these manual tasks are being forgotten because no college student wants to go and learn how to farm, although I'm sure there is some, but that was Glenn's thoughts on trying to preserve a lot of knowledge is apprenticeships. That was a real good episode. Try to get GB any way you can. Episode 23, Wednesday, October 12th, 2011. I think it was titled Hatred and Hope. Glenn was hit with a feeling, and I think he wrote it down and was thinking about it real hard. And tomorrow, or the next episode, he will write it down. Episode 24, Thursday, October 13th, 2011. This was a jam-packed show, and I left a little bit more room for this one than yesterday's episode. There was some stat I heard. U.S. spends $4.2 billion a day than it takes in. So that's not what they spend. That's just how much more they spend a day than they take in. A day. If you don't think this country needs to be fixed, you're insane. Jesse Jackson calls for... That's Jesse Jackson Jr. of Illinois, calls for a state of emergency. This idiot wants the direct hire of 15 million out of work by the government or Obama. He just wants them to hire him to do whatever, the executive branch. He also goes on to say Congress in rebellion and Obama needs to take extra constitutional powers. Basically, he's talking about the overthrow of the Congress and just martial law. And do you hear that on the media, the lamestream media? No. Unbelievable. Glenn also talked about the contrail and a Chinese connection. There was something that whenever Obama would threaten sanctions or talk about something about the Chinese, and I wasn't sure exactly what at the time when the contrail off the coast of California, I think it was, happened, but it was right when we were talking about the Chinese and doing something to, because of their currency or what have you, but he mentioned a couple other instances. Well, this happened and this happened when we were going after the Chinese verbally. So he's very suspicious that the Chinese have some kind of thing to either distract or to try to hurt America. It was a fascinating theory I had never heard before. Now, this next segment is why I bought or I subscribed to GBTV. Glenn Beck had a list, and this was 39 minutes in, like a money list, he called it. And it goes on for, I think he used all the chalkboard, his new chalkboard, and two others. And it was just a list of things, like a checklist to do. And it was unbelievable. I'm not going to go through all of them, but it's a list to save your ass if the shit hits the fan. But before the list, the 912er organizers got together, and they brainstormed about what do they need from Glenn. I think one of them said, it would be nice if you could announce some 912 projects on your show to let people know, because when Glenn Beck talks about it, people listen and are more aware. They're not getting the updates from the actual 912er organizations. I think the nexus is Glenn, and I think he might announce more organizations or more projects. Okay, back to the list. When he first put pen to paper, he had a whole other different thing he was going to talk about. It was Van Jones. But instead, he wrote this it's like a survival list. And it has, of course, gold, food, cigars, liquor, the cigars and liquor, is to barter or to bribe, because in the short term, that's what people are going to run out of first. It was a fascinating and comprehensive list. I can't see how he just came up with this all in one sitting, but that's why Glenn is Glenn. He's good. It covered everything from, how to get from one place to the other, to alliances, farmland, water. I guess that's more the money end. Then they had location was one of the titles. Traditions. He went through electronics. Another title, education. He went through a whole list through education. Glenn continues about business and jobs, like a 17 or 15 point list about life. That had about 17 things. And the last two things he didn't write down, and he just said verbally, and he was too afraid to write them down. So I'm sure he'll go over this list again. It's on GBTV.com or Glenn, one of his websites. But you really need to get GBTV if you possibly can, because there's so much good information, stuff he's been holding back from his TV show just for his web TV. Episode 25, Friday, I think that was October 14th, 2011. He had kind of a Glenn Beck for the Record, mostly on Fridays. He has like a recap, although they do some interesting segments. They've got SE Cup interviewing Dennis Miller for, I think it was a good half hour or an hour. That's it for this episode. Please get a subscription to GBTV. It's well worth the price for the knowledge that you get, the history, the knowledge, what to do. This was the week to have already had it. So I hope all my subscribers have seen this week's for sure. But the last couple weeks, well, from the beginning, it's been jam-packed full of good stuff. That's all, and I hope you come back for more episodes.